Hi. Today I am going to discuss about three phase inverters. And in last class we have discussed performance parameters of inverters. That is applicable for three phase as well as single phase inverters. And we have discussed about single phase full bridge inverter. Here we will discuss three phase inverters. That means across the output we will get three phase output voltages. Some of the basic features of three phase system is that at any instant of time, some of the voltages must be equal to zero and the voltages must be 120 degree out of phase. So based on that, we will generate switching pulses so that balanced three phase output voltage we will get. In three phase inverters, six switches and six diodes we will use. Diodes are generally not required if the load is resistive, but if the load is inductive, diode is very important. Otherwise, output voltage waveform will change. This we have discussed in single phase full bridge inverter also. So let's start. Three phase inverters are normally used for high power applications, and the output voltage can be obtained using six transistors. It may be MOSFET, IGBT, and for very high power applications, thyristor is used. And six anti-parallel diodes are required if the load is inductive. Based on the switching signals given to the switches, there are two basic modes of operations: 180 degree conduction mode and 120 degree conduction mode. The difference between the two is only the duration of conduction period of the switches. In 180 degree conduction mode, every switch will conduct for 180 degree, and in 120 degree conduction mode, every switch will conduct for 120 degree. You have to be cautious about the short circuiting of these legs, as there are three legs, 2 and 3. And 6 switches, 1, 3, 5, 4, 6 and 2. Suppose if the switch number 1 is on and anyhow the switch 4 is also turned on, then there will be dead short circuit and source may get damaged, or your load or the device connected to the inverter may get damaged. So we have to be very cautious about these things. But here in our discussion, I will assume that when switching pulses are given to the switch, instantly it will be on. There will be no delay time, and when the switching pulses are removed, switch will be off. Based on that one, we will discuss these three phase inverters. Let's start with 180 degree conduction mode. Here, a three phase star connected load is used, and the six switches are 1, 3, 5, 4, 6, 2. These numberings are done just to ease the generation of switching pulses. Now the switching pulses are given in such a way that this output voltage will be 120 degree out of phase. Based on that, the switching pulses, let's discuss. Here, switch number 1, suppose it starts with 0, then it will conduct for 120 degree, and next 120 degree it will be off, then again it will be on. So like this it will be there. For other switches also similar conduction period will be there. You can see the switch number 2 is on for 180 degree, then off for 180 degree, likewise it will continue. Similarly for switch number 3, 4 and 5, 6. One thing here you can observe that the switching pulse 1 and switching pulse 4, you can see it is complement to each other. That means when switch number 1 is on, this 4 is off, and when 1 is off, 4 is on. You can see the circuit. So when 1 is on, 4 remains off, and when 4 is turned on, then 1 is off. Just to avoid the short circuit between the two switches or the source and load. Similar case is applicable for switch number 3 and 6, 5 and 2. Let's see. You can see 3. When 3 is on, switch number 6 is off. And when 2 is on, then your 5 is off. So complementary pulses are given to these switches. So 1 and 4 are complement to each other, 2 and 5 complement to each other, 3 and 6 complement to each other. Now, to generate 120 degree out of phase of voltage, there is some delay of switching pulses. You can see switch number 1 starts from 0 and up for 180 degree, but switch number 2 starts from 60 degree and conducts for 180 degree. Switch number 3 starts from 120 degree. So 60 degree delay is given. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 2 is delayed by 60 degree from switching pulse 1. 3 is delayed by 60 degree from switching pulse 2. Likewise, it will continue. And you will see that exactly 120 degree out of phase output voltage you will get. So the reason of giving this delayed switching pulses is to obtain 120 degree out of phase output voltage. So you can see from 0 to 60 degrees. So this is 60 degree. So 0 to 60 degree, how many switches are on? So here switch number 1 is on, go down, see switch number 5 is on and switch number 6 is on. So from 0 to 60 degree, 5, 6, 1 is on. Then let's see from 60 to 120. So this is 120 and this one is 60. So 60 to 120, what are the on switches? 1 is on, 2 is on, then you see 6. So here you can see from previous 0 to 60 degree and from 60 to 120 degree. 0 to 60 and 60 to 120, there is a new switch 2 comes into action and the earlier switch 5 is turned off. So you can say after every 60 degree a new switch will come and at any instant of time 3 switches will be on. So likewise you can continue, you can observe that in 360 degree you will get 6 switching sequence. So it will start from 0 to 60 degree, 5, 6, 1, then 60 to 120, 6, 1, 2, then 120 to 180, it will be 1, 2, 3, these are off, then 180 to 240, 2, 3 and 4. That means the switches are coming like this, 5, 6, 1, then 6, 1, 2, then 1, 2, 3, then 2, 3, 4, then 3, 4, 5, then 4, 5, 6. And after this, you will see there will be again the switch number 1 will be on. So after this, here 360 degree completes 0, 180, 360. So after 360 degree, again new cycle will start. So here it is 0 to 60 degree. So here you will see 1 is on, 5 is on, 6 is on. So the cycle repeats 5, 6, 1. So likewise it will continue. So this is, so this kind of switching pulses we have to give across the 6 switches, then only we will get balanced 3 phase output voltage and the voltage and the voltages will be 120 degree out of phase. Let's see the output voltage graph. Now in from 0 to 60 degree, as we have seen here, 0 to 60 degree, the switch number 1, 5 and 6 is on. What kind of circuit will see the equivalent circuit? So switch number 1 is on, as 4 is off, it is open circuited. Then switch number 6 is on and 3 is off, so open circuited. And 5 is on, two ESOPs open circuited. So this is our conducting circuit. So current will start from the DC source. It will flow like this. Then as this switch is on, so this current will flow like this. And the current will return through this path. So you can see if this current is I, then this resistance and this resistance are in parallel. So two resistances are in parallel. So the equivalent resistance is R by 2. Along with that, this R is in series. So total resistance of the circuit becomes R by 2 plus R, 3 R by 2. So the voltage equal to, if I is the current, then V is equal to I into 3 R by 2. Now let's see the phase voltages. Voltage between this and this point, V R L. So current is flowing like this. Here also current enters, but in this case current comes out. So the polarity of the output voltage across this VRN, here it will be positive, here negative. Across this VVN, here positive, here negative. But in case of this VYN, it is opposite as current is coming out. So here it will be positive and here negative. That means VYN will be negative. So what is the value of this VRN? So VRN is equal to R by 2 into I. As I told you that this R and this R are parallel. So equivalent resistance becomes R by 2 and I is the current. So the voltage VRN is equal to voltage VBN. So these two voltages are equal. So you see VRN is equal to VBN is equal to I into R by 2. And you will get V by 3. Here is our VYN. As I told you that here it will be positive and here negative. So the voltage is now opposite. So VYN is equal to, as net current is coming out from here, so it will be I into R and negative voltage you will get. So here it is minus IR is equal to minus 2V by 3. So VRN is equal to VBN and VYN is equal to minus 2V by 3. Let's see the output voltage waveform, how it will look like. See, from 0 to 60 degree, this is our VRN, and 0 to 60, the switch number 5, 6 and 1 is on, 60 to 120, 6, 1, 2 is on, here 1, 2, 3, here 2, 3, 4, here 3, 4, 5, here 4, 5, 6, and again here it will start 5, 6, 1. So just now I have analyzed this mode or this duration, 0 to 60, switch number 5, 6 and 1 was on, and we have seen that so VRN voltage is, it is this one. So as 100 volt supply I have given, so it will be 33.3. Now see VYN, it is minus 2V by 3, that means minus 66.66, and VBN is V by 3 and it is 33.33. Again let's check that one. VRN is equal to VBN is equal to V by 3 and VYN is equal to minus 2V by 3, exactly same waveform we have got. So VRN is equal to VBN and VYN is minus 2V by 3. So you can see at any instant of time, if you add these instantaneous values between 0 to 60 degree, you will get 0 value. So this is the property of 3 phase system, that at any instant of time summation of the voltage is equal to 0. So this mode we have seen. Now let's go to 60 to 120 degree. So in this duration, the switches on are 6, 1 and 2. So when 6, 1 and 2, what kind of output voltage you will get? Let's analyze. So here 6, 1 and 2 are on. So you see the circuit diagram. 1 is on, 6 is on and 2 is on. Across these switches, current will flow in this direction. Here also it is in this direction. Now let's see. This current is again I. Then VRN is equal to I into R, and that is equal to 2V by 3. You see, VRN is equal to I into R is equal to 2V by 3. Now what about VYN and VBN? So this current is coming out. Here also current is coming out. So the polarity of the output voltage here will be positive and here it is negative. Here positive, here negative. So VYN and VBN will be negative, and that is equal to minus of, you can say, if current is I, then it will be divided in two parts, I by 2 and I by 2. So it is minus of I by 2 into R, and that is equal to minus of V by 3. So VYN is equal to minus V by 3, VBN is equal to minus V by 3, but VRN is 2V by 3. Let's see the output voltage. VRN. So you see, VRN is equal to, it is 66.66, that is 2V by 3. Now VYN, it is minus of V by 3, and VBN, it is minus of V by 3. So from 60 to 120 degree at any instant of time, if you will sum, you will get 0. Now let's see 120 to 180 degree. So this will be a complete half cycle. So 120 to 180, the switches we have seen was on 1, 2 and 3. Here 5, 6, 1, then 6, 1, 2, then 1, 2, 3. Let's see the equivalent circuit during this period. So when 1, 2 and 3 are on, see the equivalent circuit. 1 is on, 3 is on and 2 is on. So across these two, current will flow in this direction. So VRN is equal to VYN, because these two resistances are in parallel, and that is equal to I by 2 into R, and that is equal to V by 3. So here VRN is equal to VYN is equal to V by 3, and VBN is equal to minus of 2V by 3, as we have discussed. So let's see the output voltage waveform. During this period, VRN, see, so VRN is V by 3, VYN V by 3, and VBN is minus of 2V by 3. So from 0 to 180 degree, we have got summation of the instantaneous values equal to 0. Now let's see, these three phase voltages are 120 degree out of phase or not. So you see, so this starts from here, 0, this one. Then what about VYN? See, so VYN starts from here. So here is the 0 value, so it starts from here. So VYN is lagging VRN by 120 degree. So it is like this. Likewise, you can see starting point of VBN. So VBN is starting from here, it is 240 degrees. So this point is 0, this point is 0, so from here it is starting. So three phase voltages are 120 degree out of phase. So we can conclude from here that we have successfully developed our three phase system, our three phase output voltage, having sum of instantaneous values equal to 0, and the three phase voltages are 120 degree out of phase. Let's see the line voltage. This VRN, VYN, VBN are phase voltages. Let's see the line voltage. So line voltage equal to VRN minus VYN. So just subtract VRN and VYN, you will get the line voltage. So you can see the line voltage is what? It is V, then for some duration of time it is 0, then it is minus V, then 0, minus V. So this kind of output voltage waveform you will get from three phase inverter. let's analyze the waveform. Now, single phase half bridge inverter, we have discussed in detail. We have analyzed the output voltage waveform using Fourier analysis. The same thing is applicable here also, because similar kind of output voltage waveform here we are getting. So this line voltage can be represented as Vry is equal to summation of DC component plus cosine component plus sine component, and A0 and An will be equal to 0 as we have found out in single phase half bridge inverter. So I am not going to find it here. And Bn likewise you will get 4V by n pi sine n pi by 2 sine n pi by 3, where n is equal to 1 to infinity, 1, 3, 5, like this, odd number, because even numbers are, you can see 2, n is equal to 2, n is equal to 4, n is equal to 6, it will be 2 pi, 3 pi, 4 pi, or sine of n pi, it is equal to 0. So even harmonics are not present in the output voltage. Now you can see one more thing here, sine of n pi by 3. Now if n is equal to 3, again it will be sine pi. N is equal to 6, then it will be 2 pi. N is equal to 9, 3 pi. So one more thing from here, we can conclude that triplen harmonics are also not present across the line voltage. So it is one of the advantage of three phase system that TSD or total harmonic distortion of the output voltage, it will be lesser, as even harmonics are not present. At the same time, triplen harmonics are not present. That means third harmonic is not there, sixth not there, ninth not there, like this, 15th absent. So the output waveform quality is better compared to single phase system. This is one of the reason three phase system is more popular in industrial applications. Then after substituting the value of this Bn, this line voltage we can write, n is equal to 135 infinity 4b by n pi sine n pi by 3 sine n omega t plus pi by 6. The phase voltages were lagging each other by 120 degree. So the other line voltages directly we can write, Vyb is equal to this component into sine of n omega t minus pi by 2. 120 degree out of phase, then VBR omega t minus 7 pi by 6. Now let's find the RMS value of the output voltage. So here square root of 1 by 2 pi into 2. Let's see the waveform first. During this period, output voltage is B, and what is the duration? This is your 0 to 120 degree. So from 0 to 120 degree it is V, and 120 to 180 it is 0, and then again 180 to 300 it is minus B, then it is 0. So we can find RMS value of this duration, then multiplied by 2. Same thing I have done here. So you see VRMS is equal to 1 by 2 pi multiplied by 2, 0 to 120 degree, V square d omega t, and you will get 0.816 V. So here the RMS value is not equal to the DC input, but it is 81.6% of the DC input. So today I have discussed very important topic, three phase inverter, 180 degree conductor. There we have seen that at a time three switches were conducting. After every 60 degree, a new switch is turned on and the earlier one is turned off. And the sequence we have seen 561, 612, 123, 234, 456, 561. Then we have seen the switching process of all the six switches and corresponding output voltage we have verified with the help of equivalent circuit, and ultimately we have found out the instantaneous output voltage using Fourier analysis and observed that the even harmonics and triplen harmonics are absent in the output voltage waveform, the line to line voltage waveform. Then we have found out the RMS output voltage. Next class I will discuss 120 degree conduction mode of three phase inverter. and we will compare this 180 degree and 120 degree conduction load. Thank you.